Hey everyone. So, I'm just walking up a pretty steep incline. This is not the video, but I just got done recording 1 hour using my in-ear microphones, the binaural, but I was never recording the audio. I did record an intro. I did record an intro, which you're going to see in just a moment. But then after that, it's just the audio from the camera. Whew. Bit of a decline over there. So I'm just recording this to give you a heads up that there's binaural ear to ear the first 7 minutes of this video in the intro, and then after that it's all camera audio. Now, I could have not just done this video and not uploaded it. But let's roll with it. It is what it is. It was meant to happen. So, without any further ado, on with the video. Whew. Getting out of shape, Paul.
Okay, guys, you excited? They should be joining us any second now. Ah, look who it is. Thank you very much for joining us. It's great to see you. We have some friends out here who are apparently joining us as well, some crows. But I thought my my little friends from home. This is Deacon. He's in, are you in first grade? Maybe kindergarten? Yeah. And then this is DeRay. Are you in middle school or in high school now? Yeah, something like that. I haven't been out here outdoors in a while, and the opportunity presented itself. So I thought, why not do a little ASMR nature walkabout with friends. You and two little buddies. How's that sound? Okay, great. I hope you've been well, whoever and wherever you are across the world. All right, so so give me a second. Let me put these two little guys in my backpack. All right, give me just a second. All right, guys. Theato, you go. Oh, I said, this is Theato. Did I say DeRay? I get them all mixed up. We have about 10 little friends at home, so. All right, get in there. There you go. Are you comfortable? Okay, great. Deacon, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. All right, guys. Just leave that. Yeah, they'll be fine. They can breathe and everything. So, all right, there we go. So I have my in-ear microphones. True binaural. So it will capture the sound just as your ears would. Pretty much as true to that as possible. And I'm here at Ridley Creek State Park. It's close to where I live. I don't come here quite as often anymore, because I just go for a walk where I live, and it's kind of a bit of a travel and a ride. Doesn't make much sense to get in the car, use up gas to come here to walk when I can just go out my front door and walk. So, anyway, and I'll be taking you along here. We'll get ready to go here in a moment. And so it is the beginning of March, 2024. Winter is pretty much come to an end here, southeastern Pennsylvania. So winter 2023-2024 is pretty much over, and spring is here. This is going to be the best day of the week ahead. I mean, doesn't matter when you're watching this or tuning in, but for the rest of the week, at the time of this recording, it's going to rain. Slight little breeze blowing some of the dried leaves on some of the branches. So the opportunity just prevented itself, and also presented itself. And I just, pretty much what I've been doing on this channel since 2011, just whatever the synapses and chemicals in my brain think is the best thing to do. I've been doing that all my life. Okay, so what do you say? Should we get ready and go on our little walkabout? Okay, great. Well, let's get started.
All right, so this is where we are, Rindley Creek State Park. There is my car in the background, 2012 Honda Civic, and I plan to run that thing into the ground. Here are some picnic tables, which have been kind of, I don't know what's happened there. Over there, closed for the winter, are restrooms. So they board them up. I can zoom in there a little bit. That building back there. All right. Actually, I'm not zooming in. Yeah, you actually have bionic eyes. You can zoom in. I'm just walking behind you. Alright. Alright, so let us head down a little trail here. There is a little bit of a fire pit, campfire. Looks like it's been recently used. There are no cabins here. You can't sleep here. And I don't think there's any camping grounds. Well, there are no camping grounds. I don't think there's anywhere to put a tent. So and I'm going to try to take my time here. Try not to walk too fast. So, yeah, the weather is warming up a little bit, but as you can see, everything is still bare. There might be some tiny buds of leaves starting to grow, but yeah, this is the end of winter.
pretty much. We did get some snow on a couple of occasions. But it was the opportunity to come out here and walk around in the snow didn't really present itself. So, my friend, thank you very much for joining me. I was going to say virtually, but you are actually here with me. I can see you. You're walking in front of me. Okay. There was someone that came jogging through. But, yeah, this place gets its, same place I've been traveling, coming to for ever since I started this channel. So yeah, there is a slight breeze. I think that might have been a woodpecker that you heard. You might have heard just now. Pennsylvania wildlife, not too exotic. Obviously, or not obviously, depending upon where you live in the world. But all depending upon where you live in the world, but I mean, there's no monkeys or, you know, that kind of exotic lions. From what I understand, I think there used to be mountain lions a little more common here in Pennsylvania. Well, I mean, obviously the further back in time you go, the more there is, more wildlife. So, obviously, the more developed a place becomes, the less wildlife. But even with some development here in Pennsylvania, there used to be a little bit more mountain lions. Further up north, where it gets more mountainous. But down here in the southeast region, or the southern region of Pennsylvania, it gets more, it's more rural and, still hilly terrain, valleys, but less mountainous,
more flat, more rural. So but yeah, the wildlife here in Pennsylvania, is pretty limited, not very exotic. There's deer, the occasional black bear in northern Pennsylvania. Foxes. And then your common wildlife, you know, birds local to the area, Canadian geese, which are quite common, squirrels, etc. Small snakes. But yeah, you come here to the Mid-Atlantic region, you're not getting a lot of exotic wildlife. So anywho, there is Ridley Creek, and you might not be able to see it, but there is, in the distance, I'm going to zoom in here. If you can see right in the middle of the screen, there is, might be someone fishing. I think they're by themselves, just fishing. So you can fish here. I don't know what's here, maybe trout. You know, small fish like that. But I love the sound of the water, the flowing water. Sorry if camera is a little shaky and whatnot. Hopefully it's not too bad. The camera does have image stabilizing, so yeah. But I could sit here . Someone is fishing, has a little net, tackle box, I think. And the other unfortunate thing, well, it's not too unfortunate, all depends on how you look at it, but the overhead planes, that's pretty much anywhere you go anymore across the world. So there's always some noise, pollution. There's a whole bunch of foamy water. Or, well, not foamy water, but foam.
And I think that's just from the water splashing up against the rocks. And then, I mean, that's my best guess. I'm gonna see if we can go down there. I know we can go down here. We can get to that big rock. Not sure if I want to do that. Let's go check out. Check out the Sudsy foam. Now, because I have my binaural microphones, the audio is gonna move around. So right now you hear the creek on your right side. But as I turn my head, you should hear the running water more towards the left. Okay, let's see if we can do this. Let's see if we can get down here. It's a little steep. I want to do it. So I'm gonna hold the camera. The camera is on a little monopod kind of thing. Comes with my tripod. So I'm gonna try to do this, holding the camera, record this. But worst case, I'll just cut all this out. If I slip and fall to my death, this will be how I die. Okay. It's a good thing the tree's here. I can hold on to that. A little outcropping here. That's where we were. All right, just a few feet more. It's a little muddy. All right, get some footing here. There is a nice, strong root I hold on to here. I can't help. Sorry, the camera is all. There we go. I still got it. And that's where we were. I love climbing around. I don't do it that often. I haven't climbed like that in a couple years, I guess. Used to do a lot of climbing around in trees as a kid. Anywho, here is that foamy talking. See how distorted it gets.
give it a nose, give it a smile. There you go. So I love this. I could just sit here all day. So crows, this camera doesn't have a really good zoom. There's a crow on the right in the middle of the screen. On a branch, there's a black shape. That's a crow. There it goes. It just flew down. Maybe there's something about flowing water. And there's two crows. There's three crows. I guess I figured in our 15 minutes of fame, there's our little smiley face. Okay, so I'm not going to be able to, let's see if I can make my way that way. I love this stuff. You can see what I'm walking on. I think we can get right over that little spot. Oops. Okay. I don't know about you, but I love the look of that. You see all the roots? Okay. There's a road beyond the tree line. And if I parked over there, there's a trail that leads over to the other side. And I could probably have gotten onto that little island of rocks. Look at all those rocks. I'm gonna have to come out here and make a video. And I just set the camera down and we look at all the different rocks. I just want to get my hands in there and just pick those rocks up. Okay, so let's head back. Do-do-do-do-do. Over there. So bear with me and the camera. Actually, it's not the camera. It's your head, right? Because I'm behind you, walking behind you. You're walking in front of me.
So, okay. I think we can do this. It's a little sketchy. Do-do-do-do-do. Some little footholds. There we go. Yeah, I love this too. The lichen or the moss. That's so soft. Love it. Love to see the green. That's why I do these videos. Not just for myself, whoops, for the for my own mental health. For anyone else who enjoys them. Obviously, duh. So, I thought that was a hole. It's not a hole, it's just rock. I don't think there's anything living back there. Possibly. But cracking of the branches. Okay. Here's two little, what they call water spiders. That was actually three. Let's see if I can zoom in here. I think they call them water spiders, water skippers, whatever. There's two more over there. That's pretty much the only zoom out here. That's pretty much the only life or insect life at this point. All right, this is gonna be sketchy to walk on. I think I can make some footholds. Hold on to some of these branches. Yeah, that's not going anywhere. So, a little rocky right here. Okay, let's see if we can do this without falling into the water, slipping. Grab on. There we go. Alright, we'll make our way to maybe around here. Okay. Yeah, this is not bad. Oh, here's some rocks. Try to get the camera in position here. This is such a great primal thing. Just, why do I like doing this? I've been doing this ever since a kid, looking under rocks for bugs, slugs, snails. Sometimes you lift a rock up, see a small snake, salamander. Look at this here. This is cool. Here's a little bud. Okay, looking around after setting down the bud. Okay. And I think the reason this is feels very primal and I love doing this is because I'm just picturing our ancestors looking under rocks for bugs to eat. Why else do I like doing this? It's just, I love it. Or I have ADHD, and it's that, I don't know. Okay. Now we're gonna make our way back. Camera's not focusing back there. A little sandy outcropping, a little rocky outcropping. But there's some more of the flowing water. I don't think we're gonna be going very far today. Normally on my walks, previous videos, I will just not stay in one place. Lots of rocks here. Broken glass. Oops. Gotta be careful with the glass. Too many different kinds of rocks. I would love to collect them. Have a rock collection. You would never be able to stop. Because there's so many different shapes and sizes and colors. I mean, look at this. Pebbles. Pebbles, pebbles, pebbles. Not sure if you, how long you've been a subscriber, but my long-term viewers and subscribers will be familiar with the pebble that I had in a couple videos. I lost that pebble, believe it or not. I have no idea where it went. Let's throw this pebble. One. Throw a couple pebbles, some rocks. You remember doing this as a kid? Do you do this yourself? And just pretend that's your hand. And if you're not Caucasian, just pretend you have a Caucasian hand. It's just a pigment. Our physical appearance doesn't define who we are. Okay. Let's meander. Let's climb up here. And we'll go over there. I guess getting out of here is going to be a little interesting. This is a nice strong branch. See this root? It's not on a branch, it's a root from this tree. Oh, I love the roots. Comes here and then splits. And it goes back in. I'm gonna step a foot up here. Grab onto that. And there we go. Boost myself up. And there we go. All right. I would love to get onto that giant boulder. Well, as you can see, there's about a 2-foot gap. And that's, yeah, I don't feel like risking that. If I wasn't holding a camera, I would risk climbing. I wouldn't walk. I'd probably crouch along the that fallen tree the other side. I'm sure some kids have done that. I'm a kid at heart. I'm not a kid physically anymore. So giant tree. See, it's cloudy today. Take a look up there. As above, so below. Pretty soon, a couple months, it's all gonna be green. Won't be able to see very far. Can't wait. I will make another trip out here come spring, I hope. Lots of roots. I hope you have been enjoying this little jaunt with me as much as I have been enjoying it with you. And of course, I still got the kids with me in my backpack. This tree fell over a long time ago. I'm assuming sometimes when the creek, I don't know how high it might, it's not gonna get that high. I was gonna say when the creek gets high, oh, torrential rain, flood, it's gonna come over that bank, and this little, whatever you wanna call this part, where it might fill up, it might fill up from there and then come this way. Get up here. More rocks. I don't want to get too close to all that because it's going to be really loud. But we can definitely zoom in. It's pretty much as close as we can get. And zoom out. Okay. More rocks to be had. I wonder if there's any gold. I doubt there's any gold in this area. They would have found it a long time ago. But I would like to, maybe that's a good idea for a video. Get one of those sifting things. So you can sift through the sediment. Yeah, for rocks or whatever. Okay, let us make our way. Let's make our way back. And we'll go up. To where it's, just get away from the water. It's a little more quiet. There we go. Some natural earth-made stairs. It's perfect. Oh, here's a little hole. Maybe a mouse, maybe something, I don't know. Anybody home? Hello? Could be a mole, right? I don't know. I'm no expert. I know some. I know a lot about some things. Computers. I've been behind a computer since the 90s, built a computer, so I know a lot about that. I know a decent amount about nature, types of wildlife, birds, habits. Look, here's another hole. Anybody home? Right, this is what you're gonna do as a kid, or as an adult. I'm gonna get a stick, and see if anything comes out. How deep is that hole? It goes down pretty deep. And anything coming out? Yeah, I don't think so. I mean, who knows how... Who knows how old or new that hole is, but nobody was home, so, which might be a good thing, because I don't think I want somebody poking a stick in my house and getting angry little mole, little mouse coming out and biting my finger. And that'd not be a good thing. Okay, let's get these 53, soon to be 53 year old legs up this. All right, look at that tree. I wonder when that fell over. Oh, it's been a while, I think. Not sure if I ever noticed that before. It looks like a fresh... Looks like some other... Let's walk over there. Excuse to walk in the dry leaves. Okay. That's good enough. Zoom in a little bit. So you can see the tree splintered. I wonder how old that looks, kinda. It's not, didn't happen this year. Doesn't look that fresh. If that happened recently or this year, oops. It'd be more
bright, the wood would be more bright colored, tan colored, like these leaves. But that looks like that tree fell over a couple years ago, I want to say. Maybe a year ago. Alright, so we're going to go back up the way we came. See these boulders from a different angle. And just this whole place just speaks to how I wish I was a hunter-gatherer. Living out here, no worries about bills, no worries about rent. Ooh, chipmunk. Dude, chipmunk. Middle of your screen. So awesome. There it goes. It's right between the... it's gone. I hope you saw that. Oh no, there it is again. It's on this... yeah, it's right on that rock. Nope. Man, that's so hard to spot. Yeah, it's going. Yeah, it went into that fallen tree. All these trees in the front. Man, that was so cool. Chipmunks are really, really... I think that crow was excited, saw a chipmunk too. Chipmunks, despite contrary to popular belief, chipmunks are not priests that worship potato chips. Chipmunks worship computer chips. Chipmunks are actually cute, striped, little, tiny squirrels. So, alright, so, well, I'm not too out of shape. That's a good thing. So, we're gonna walk a little bit more. Yeah, that will do our little visit together. So let's head down this way. Alright. Yeah, chipmunks, well, like most wildlife, but small wildlife, well, all wildlife will see you before you see it. But chipmunks, they're really... Something else is moving out here, I think. Or maybe moving behind me. I am hearing impaired, starting in 2009. Slowly, I lost my hearing in my left ear. And I've mentioned this over the years on my channel, with pretty much 95% total hearing loss as of 2015, something like that. So I am mono. I went from stereo to mono. But, yeah, chipmunks, you rarely ever see them. They're so cool. There's a lot of them around, but they're really hard to see because they blend in with the environment. So, just taking a moment to look around. You can see it's cloudy. Because, yep. It's going to be raining the rest of the week. as far as the time, the date of this video being posted. But yeah, there is a, there's some squirrels running around. There is a part of me that yearns for the primitive life, for the indigenous life, for a natural life. Ever since I was a kid, climbing trees, looking under rocks, loving being outdoors. And as much as I love technology, cameras, doing this, doing that, I love this just as much, even more, maybe. And, you know, are you the same way? Do you feel like a calling and a yearning to be outdoors? There is another chipmunk. Oh, you're not gonna see it. It's on. Yeah, I can see it, but it's right in the middle of my screen on that log. But the log, there's so many branches. Yep, I see it. It's on that fallen tree. You see, if you can, like, right in the middle of my screen. Let's see if I can turn on manual focus. Right, so we're gonna focus on that log. Where's that log at? There we go. Alright, so you see that tree? Middle of the screen? Yeah. There is a chipmunk. Trying to fit right in the middle of the screen. And then I'll try to crop. Do a zoom crop with the camera. But he's right in the middle of the screen. In that little area right there where those branches cross each other. There's a little space right in there. And he hasn't moved. Let's see if I can come around. Oops. If I come around this side. Alright, I can see his head. Alright, there he is. Hey. Alright, so there's the... Hopefully you can see the chipmunk. It's just... sitting... You follow the green of the log. The moss. He's right there in the center of the screen. I can't zoom in anymore. But he's there. Can you see that little brown shape in the middle of the screen? I'm going to try to crop in post-processing, but it's right there. He's turned to look at us. If I go any closer, oops. Yeah, you should see him. It, her. Right out. Yeah, right there. You see that little... Yeah, you should be able to see it, I think. Chipmunk. Okay. Alright, chipmunk. We'll see you later. I'll zoom out here. Wow, it's actually just sitting still because, well... probably thinks we are a predator. Do you hear that sound? I don't know if that's a squirrel. Is that duck? Birds? What was that little chattering? You hear that chirp? That's the chipmunk. That's a chipmunk. Sometimes cardinals. Come on, man. Why do you gotta drop your crap in the woods? You know what? I bet you didn't drop it. There was a woman jogging through earlier. What is this? What do we find? What is, you know, welcome to modern society where you find junk, trash. We got Laneige, lip glowy balm. I can't read that far away. Lip glowy balm, berry. So. Why am I gonna try to open that? Am I nuts? So I'm gonna just, I don't know, I'll just leave it here. Do I throw it out or leave it for the person that, like, oh, that was my berry. Oh, what, you know, I don't know. What do I do? I'm gonna, I think the universe told me to come out here to do this video so I would find this, so I throw it out. That's what I'm gonna do, put it in my back pocket. Toss that. Okay. I mean, I participate in society, right? I use society. I throw trash out. What is that chattering? What the hell is that? Frogs. That's frogs. All right. Tree frogs or something. Yeah, I don't know if you can see all the way down there. A little bit of water, swampy. Oh, this is cool. This has been a great adventure with you, my friend. Frogs. I'm putting my ear up to my right ear. I'm putting my hand up, my palm, my right palm, up to my right ear. Moving my head around so I can... Yeah, I think the frogs are down there somewhere. So cool. Frogs! Yeah, I think they're down there somewhere. Zoom in again. Yeah, it's all swampy. Sure, there's frogs down there. Somewhere down there. All right, I'm gonna zoom out. All right, so thank you very much for joining me. I'm so glad I had this opportunity to be out here. It's great for me. I hope this was great for you. I really wish you could be out here. You know. But, I don't know. Is that something I want to do? I was just thinking about, what if I arranged a nature hike with some viewers? You know, just a safety concern, because obviously, but if we were to meet in a public space, like, hey, let's meet up at a local restaurant, parking lot, you know, and then, okay, and maybe drive from there to the place, or, right, because you got to make sure people feel safe, someone's coming by themselves, you know, especially a woman or something, someone who's not very strong, or, you know, that, I don't mean all women aren't strong, but a young person, it doesn't matter, woman,
non-binary, more frogs. But yeah, that made me, you know, I thought about that off and on over the years. The reason I've never done a hike with viewers is, and not to be on camera, just do it off camera for everybody's privacy and just to be myself. Maybe that's something I could do. The only reason I haven't done that, out of fairness to other people across the world, who I would very much love to go on a hike with, but and maybe that's something I could do come the summer, maybe this summer. Arrange. I'm just spitballing here. I mean, but arrange a safe hike with viewers somewhere in Pennsylvania. Maybe they'll make some friends themselves, and we just chat, talk. People from all walks of life, skin color, doesn't matter. All right, what was that? Something going through those branches. Sounded like it might be something more than just a squirrel snapping branches like that. I don't see anything out here. Yeah. And I thought about like traveling the world to meet viewers. I mean, but that's insane. As much as I would love to. You know, I have a family. I like the simple life, being at home and just making a little bit of money, living a very, you know, I can't travel. Well, there's safety issues, you know, and I'm not gonna leave my wife and son, travel the world, and he's in school. But you know how you dream sometimes, right? I love to help people that, you know, need help. I love to change the world, make it better. But who am I to do that? Who is anyone to say this is how the world should be? Maybe all that's happening in the world is what's supposed to happen, because that is life. It's chaos. There's no order. You can try to bring order with your politics and this or that, but time and time again throughout the history of our species, you know, I'm not going to mention everything, but there's been conflicts of all kind. And I don't think the conflict among our species is ever going to stop. But what we can do is try to do the best in the, you know, we never asked to be born here. No, you know, I wasn't asked to be born Caucasian in here in the United States, Pennsylvania, where it's not a war zone or a place of conflict. So I am just this human being out of billions that have ever existed, will ever exist, and I'm just talking and doing this thing that I do. But just, you know, make the best, you know. I like it when people, what is this on this log? The heck is that? Oh, I smell skunk. I got a whiff of, skunk, or someone's, smoking something, but it smells like skunk. For a second. What is this right here? It's kind of webbed. Oh, it's a whole bunch of, what is that? Is that like owl? Chewed up owls? You know how,
owls and cats will regurgitate stuff. They call it pellets. When owls eat mice, and they'll regurgitate the bones, the things they can't eat and digest. All right, someone's just walking through with their dogs. What were we talking about? Yeah, so whoever you are, even the people out there who are never gonna watch this and who are never gonna hear this message, I hope the only people the only people I care about, but the people I care mostly about are the people you don't even know exist. The people in your other apartment building, the people down the street, and the people that I really root for is anyone, regardless. I think that's a chipmunk. Let's walk down this way. Regardless of gender, ethnicity, you're indigenous, you live in modern society, regardless of age, the people that I really root for, the people that you don't even know exist, who just go trying to get through life, they like a simple life. They might, have their possessions, but they're not greedy. And they're just, just trying to better themselves. I'm gonna turn the camera around. Okay, there we go. So, the people that I root for and pull for, whether you're young, older, like I said, the people you don't even know exist, right, they don't have YouTube channels, that's what I mean. The people who are our neighbors, people who live in the next county over, next city. The people who may be smoking, drinking alcohol, but they're thinking about quitting. Maybe they never smoked or drank. Oops, a little wobbly. The people who may have smoked and drank alcohol and have quit. People trying to improve themselves and their lives. Physically, mentally. People who are trying to just better themselves day to day, get through life, maybe get a better job, maybe even if they have side hustles or they're gambling because they live in an area that's not very great, and they want to move to a better place. They want a nice, simple little house. I shouldn't even have to say a better place. I'm going to turn around because I think the sun is behind me. And I talk to you. Yeah, sun's right up there. I can talk to you. I'm not in the shadow. But that's the people who I root for. Not necessarily underdogs. They could be making, minimum wage, or they could be making 30, 40, 50,000, 80, 100,000 a year. They're not wealthy, they're not rich, they might own a home, but you just don't hear about them. Keep to themselves. They try to live as healthy as they can. They don't need to be the smartest people in the world. They don't need to know about anarchism. Whether it's maybe that's your parents, your mom, single mom, single dad, you, your siblings, you just want to get through life without being or doing the crazy things that you hear on the news. That's the people I always think about. I'm not trying to virtue signal. No, but I mean, the only reason I'm here on YouTube is because of this. I need to do this. Create. I was not happy with any of the real, quote unquote, real world jobs, desk jobs. And so I need to do the YouTube channel. But I would prefer just to be another person you didn't even know existed. And not be on YouTube. But there's no other job that I'll be happy doing. So it's a catch-22 for me. Conundrum. Alright. So at this point, I just want to say thanks again for joining me. It was great to have you. It was great to see you. And I hope we get a chance to do this again. I gotta take the kids back home. They need lunch. I need lunch. And wish you all my best, no matter who you are, across the world. And I'm pulling for you. I'd hope that your life gets better, improves, you know, especially if it's not in a good state right now, whether where you live or your own body. But you know, all we can do is our best. So take care. And I'm just gonna walk, turn the camera away from me, walk down this path, and we'll fade out. All right so wish you all my best. Stay well, stay safe, take care. Hope to see you in another video real soon. So long and take care for now. Okay. Right, there was no one behind me. That's the thing with having one good ear and not being able to hear both sides. I can't really hear well who's coming, who's going. Now that chirp could be a chipmunk or a cardinal. They both make those same kind of chirps. A little bit of a sandy, I hate to touch it, but dry sand on top. And we got the moist, wet sand. Look at that. Yeah, that's a great feeling. Oh, I love that. All right, I think that's enough. Let's walk here and we'll fade out.